My name is Sister Connie Charette. I was born in Leominster, Massachusetts in 1940. I was one of six children, and we lived in an enclave called French Hill. So our whole life as children, family, centered around a national French, Canadian parish. I think every Catholic girl at one time or another goes to a Catholic school thinks maybe she'd like to be a sister.
Sometimes I wish my eyes hadn't been opened. Sometimes I wish I could no longer see all of the pain and the hurt and the longing of my sisters and me as we try to be free. Sometimes I wish my eyes hadn't been opened just for an hour. How sweet it would be not to be struggling, not to be striving, but just sleep securely in our slavery. But now that I've seen with my eyes, I can't close them, because deep inside me, somewhere I'd still know the road that my sisters and I have to travel. My heart would say yes, and my feet would say go. Sometimes I wish my eyes hadn't been opened, but now that they have, I'm determined to see that somehow my sisters and I will be one day the free people we were created to be. That somehow my sisters and I will be one day the free people we were created to be.
Recently, I was walking in the cemetery where our sisters are buried. The sisters who have died since 1902 are here in St. Mary's Cemetery. And it's just very striking. There's probably 350 stones. They're such a symbol of the power of the Spirit. I think this is looking at the harvest of the first sisters who came to America and what has happened in all these years, the work that has gone into the ministries that we have had here in the United States. And I look at them, and often enough I say to myself, how did my life get all intertwined with all these other people from Vermont and Connecticut and Massachusetts and France? It's sort of like this is my heritage. And just talking with another sister yesterday, and we were just talking about journeying in our prayer with some of the sisters here who have impacted our lives. We sort of said it's important. If these women were such fine women, and they could live like Sister Marie Michaud, who just died, you know, at the end of her life can say, I have no regrets. I have had a happy life. I feel like I've been so enriched. Well, that gives me hope for myself too, and Bonnie, what I was talking with. And we said, all of this, if that could be a way of life that could bring these women to such a noble way of dying, then I'm proud to be of this stock. This is my heritage, and I'm not sorry in the least.
I pray you'll be alright and watch us where we go and help us to be wise in times when we don't know.
Good to me. He sent me the most beautiful daughter. I was so proud of her. She became a nun, Sister Connie.
Sento che ci salve.